Hello again, and welcome to another Teacher Time with Kelsey. Today we are going to be doing our author spotlight, and I have a story from one of the children in the Olive Room to share. So today we are going to be sharing a story written by Olive Say. It's a story that I know a lot of our Olive Room children will connect with because we've been really into spooky stories, and I'm hoping it's a story that a lot of other children are really going to enjoy too, but I'm sure you are. There's a lot of great things in it. There's a lot of spooky parts, a lot of surprises, a lot of mystery to it, and I know those are things that you all usually really love too. Something that I thought was pretty cool about Olive's story as I was kind of reading through it was that she actually, her characters in the story are inspired by people in her life. So she uses herself, she uses her dog Scruff, she even uses her family. So I thought that was really interesting to be able to kind of gather from the people that she knows and use them as inspiration. And I also really loved that Olive has this kind of spooky idea, but she also tries to help balance it so it's not so spooky too. So sometimes I know things can get really scary, but I think Olive has a really good way of kind of making things scary and then bringing them back to have them be fun and exciting too. So it was pretty fun to be able to read that and see how she navigated that story. And the other thing that I really like about her story is that something that we actually talked about a little earlier in the week on Teacher Time with Kelsey, of the way that Olive uses her language. So she uses a lot of descriptive language and she uses sounds so that you can really see the pictures in the story and I think really get into the world of it. But I noticed when I was looking through her story that she doesn't just do that with her words, but she also does it with her illustrations. So when I am reading you the story today, what I would like to do is, instead of just reading you the words, I want you to really be able to see Olive's pictures. So I'm going to read one page and then I'll show you the picture for that page. That way you can really hear the descriptions that she has, but then also see how Olive illustrated them too with her pictures. So I'm excited to be able to share both of those parts with you and for you guys to get to see Olive's work. And so we can get started, get your drink and your cozy spot. We're going to be doing lots of stories today, so make sure you're really comfortable. And we will start with Olive's story titled The Darkness. First, I take somebody's eyeballs out who are dead. Then I plant an eyeball tree. And then I feed them to Scruff because eyeballs are Scruff's favorite food. And Scruff eats the eyeballs from the eyeball tree. And then Scruff howls, "Ow! Ow! 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 Ow!" But little did Olive know the reason from Scruff's howling, the eyeballs were from a crocodile. Amber came and said, "Why is Scruff howling?" And then Olive said, "Because I fed her eyeballs." And then Olive went over to the eyeball tree and she figured out it was a crocodile's eyeballs, poisonous. But Scruff still survived, even though the eyeballs were poisonous. The reason why she survived is because she has a poisonous-proof, lava-proof coat that made her not get poisoned or killed. And Olive's family had no idea that Scruff was a magic dog. One night when Scruff was sleeping, she knew they were poisonous eyeballs. Little did Olive's family know that Scruff could talk. And then Olive took somebody's brains out that was already dead and planted a brain tree. And then the type of brain that was in Scruff, that grew. Thank you. Scruff's brain came out. Then she got it back because it was a scruff brain tree. Then she could think and hear again. Because you know your ears don't make you hear, right? Your brain actually makes you hear. The end. So that was Olive's story, The Darkness. I'm sure it's one that a lot of you guys really enjoyed, and I am so excited that we got to share that with you and got to share some of Olive's artwork. This is a story that she actually just created too, so it's a story that no one from Little Owl has really had a chance to hear yet. So that's a pretty special thing that we got to share it here, and thank you so much, Olive, for letting me share that for you too. The other thing that we are going to do is Olive gave us her own story to share, but she also gave us a book recommendation too of a story that she would like us to retell. So today, Olive's story that she chose is The Napping House, which I know is a favorite for a lot of people, by Audrey Wood and Dawn Wood. This is a story that some of you might have seen that Chelsea also read with Harper. So you guys probably have heard this story recently and gotten familiar with it. Today, we are actually going to retell it in a different way. So a lot of you probably know that Olive, her mom, Amber, actually does yoga at Little Owl with us. So yoga is something that's really special for Olive and her family. So I thought that one great way to honor Olive's book recommendation would be to actually retell this book through yoga. So what I did is I thought of some yoga poses that connect with some of the characters and things that are happening in the book. And we are going to go through a little mini yoga flow as we retell this story and just retell it with our bodies. So for this, you will need a little bit more space than you normally do. So just make sure that the spot that you're in has room for you to be able to do poses. If you have a yoga mat that you might like to use, or a blanket, whatever seems to work best for you, you can get that stuff ready too. And then we will start retelling The Napping House. Before we start, I want to show you a couple poses we'll be using in our flow. First is corpse pose. We'll be using this to show us sleeping. To do this pose, lie on the ground on your back with your feet slightly apart and your arms at your sides. Next, we'll do constructive rest. This will be the pose we use to show our bed. To do this pose, lie on the floor with your arms at your side and your knees bent. Next, we'll do wind release. This will be the pose we use to show our grandma. To do this pose, lie on the ground on your back and bring both legs to your chest, wrapping your arms around your shins. Next, we'll enter child's pose to show our child. Start by kneeling and sit back on your heels. Bend all the way forward and rest your forehead on the floor. Put your arms at your sides. Next, we'll go into downward facing dog to be our dog. Start by sitting on your heels. Move on to all fours, and keeping your hands on the ground, extend your legs and bring your bottom up into the air. Next, we'll go into cat pose to show our cat. Start by going onto all fours, and then round your back up like a cat. Next is frog pose. This is what we'll use to become our mouse. Start by sitting back on your heels and spreading your knees apart. Then, bend your head forward and rest your forehead on the ground. Our last pose will be cosmic egg. This will be our flea. To do this pose, sit on the ground and hug your knees up to your chest, lifting your feet off the ground just slightly. Now that you know the poses, join me in our Napping House yoga flow. The Napping House by Audrey Wood. There is a house, a napping house, where everyone is sleeping. And in that house, there is a bed, a cozy bed, in a napping house where everyone is sleeping. And on that bed, there is a granny, a snoring granny on a cozy bed in a napping house where everyone is sleeping. And on that granny, there is a child, a dreaming child on a snoring granny, on a cozy bed, in a napping house, where everyone is sleeping. And on that child, there is a dog. A dozing dog on a dreaming child, on a snoring granny, on a cozy bed, in a napping house where everyone is sleeping. And on that dog, there is a cat, a snoozing cat, on a dozing dog, on a dreaming child, on a snoring granny, on a cozy bed, in a napping house, where everyone is sleeping. And on that cat, there is a mouse, a slumbering mouse, on a snoozing cat, on a dozing dog, on a dreaming child, on a snoring granny, on a cozy bed, in a napping house, where everyone is sleeping. And on that mouse, there is a flea. Can it be? A wakeful flea? On a slumbering mouse, on a snoozing cat, on a dozing dog, on a dreaming child, on a snoring granny, on a cozy bed, in a napping house, where everyone is sleeping. A wakeful flea who bites the mouse. Who scares the cat. Who claws the dog? Who thumps the child? Who bumps the granny? Who breaks the bed? In the napping house, where no one now is sleeping. And that was our retelling of the napping house. I hope that that was something that you guys were able to get really into. I hope that you got a chance to do some of the poses with us too. I know that I've never told a story that way before with yoga poses and with my body in that way. So it was really interesting to be able to just explore a new way to share a story And maybe it's something that you guys will continue exploring with other books as well. So I hope that it's something that will inspire you, and I am looking forward to sharing more books with you when we come back to another Teacher Time with Kelsey. Thank you again to Olive for that book recommendation and for sharing your story, and I hope that you all have a great weekend. Bye!